thanks so much for joining me today for a new tutorial. I'm creating a fun nautical scene from the new center picture window die from Lawn Fawn, and I wanted to show you how you can use this die to create scenes of your own. You don't necessarily have to create some nautical scenes like I did here with some of the new stamps and dies from Lawn Fawn's latest release. However, the concept of putting these cards together is exactly the same no matter how you decorate it. And I wanted to show you how I created mine so that you can use these dies to create some fun 3D effects of your own. So let's get started. I have all of the dies from the center picture window die set laid out here on my desk. One of the main elements is the card panel, so we're going to use that to build our center picture window. This little tabbed panel is the element that creates the 3D effect. You also get this fun T-bar, which is perfect for creating score lines on any elements that you want to add to your 3D picture window card that doesn't already have score lines on them. These pieces do have score lines. There's a fun little banner for stamping sentiments. There's a few little hills and straight bars so that you can add things to your center picture window cards. A little oval to cut the window into your 3D panel. And some fun embellishments. I'm going to start by taking the card panel and the tabbed panel. These are the two main elements for creating the center picture window cards. I'll cut these from some brown cardstock. This is some Desert Storm. And I'm going to then take that tabbed panel and line up that middle section of the die with the score line. So you can see these little metal pieces of the die. The score line is going to be in the middle of those two little metal areas. I'll run that through my die cut machine so that I have my window cut perfectly into the center of this tabbed panel. Setting these pieces aside, I'm also going to use the tabbed panel to cut out some of these beautiful scalloped rainbow papers from Lawn Fawn. The reason I'm using the tabbed panel is because if you cut off the tabs, it saves you from having to measure an area on these cards because these panels are perfectly sized to fit onto these cards once you cut the tabs off. So if you want to add some backgrounds like I want to for my center picture window, I'll just take this panel, fold it in half, and cut the tabs off. Once I do this, this is perfectly sized to go behind my center picture window scene, and it's not going to have any areas showing through of another color. Moving back over to the center picture window itself, I'm folding over the tabs and scoring them with my bone folder to give them a really good crease. I'm doing that to both sides, and then I'm also going to fold the entire piece in half. Once I have this completely folded, I'm then going to take some 1/8 inch tape. This is just some straight double-sided tape. And I'm going to adhere that to both tabs on the front side of this picture window tab panel. On one side, I'm going to take off the release paper. Don't do this to the other side yet. I'm going to open up the card, and this is the inside of the card, and I'm going to fold this over so that I can nest the edge of that center picture window into the fold and sandwich that tab onto the card. This is making sure that my center picture window panel is in the exact place. Next, I'm going to take the background, and on one side, I'm going to add a little bit of adhesive. And it will not only create a background for my center picture window, but it'll also hide the tab that you can see there on the card. So I'll just fold that and sandwich it in place, and as you can see, now this has a really nice finished look. And I'll just go ahead and go over everything with my bone folder again to make sure it's all really creased well. Next, I'm going to fold my picture window panel back over to the right-hand side of the card. And with that release paper taken off, I'm going to sandwich that tab onto my card. Now I can just add a little bit more adhesive to the other side of my background and sandwich that then onto the card to hold it down on the other side of my background. And at this point, I have my entire 3D center picture window scene built. This is the housing for everything we're going to embellish it with. I'm really loving how this 3D dimensional effect is so easy to achieve and creates some really awesome scenes. Now remember, I had cut that red scalloped paper and I trimmed off the tabs of this one just like I did the blue piece. Well, those pieces fit perfectly onto the edges that are exposed inside of the card. So if I take those fun little scalloped panels, I can cover up the brown card base and create some really nice color on the inside too, without having to do any sort of measurement. At this point, now that my card is built, I'm ready to put together some panels that I can use for creating my 3D elements. So I cut one of the little hills that come in the center picture window die set, and I'm folding over the tabs and giving everything a nice crease. There are also, like I said, score lines in the middle of each of those pieces, and I'll just crease those as well. So that way everything is nice and clean when it folds. I also cut a fun little wave, and I cut it to the same length as one of these picture window ground pieces that I just worked on. However, because this one was made from a different Lanfon die, I needed to add a score line. So I just made a score line in the center, and I'm using some double-sided tape to attach these to the inside of my box. So after I've creased everything and removed the release paper, I'm going to turn this upside down, and working along the bottom of my 3D picture window card, I'm going to adhere these just a little bit in from the front portion of this card. This closes super well once we've got this attached down because we've got those nice score lines and everything holds together because of that double-sided tape. Next, on one of those little hillside pieces that do come in the center picture window set, I used some palm trees from the new palm tree border die from Lanfon and attached those to the one side of this little panel. I'm going to use those tabs again a little bit further in from my wave that I already added down. And again, I'm adding these along the bottom portion of the card. I am working upside down at the moment. But once I've sandwiched those in place, these fold just as well as the first set and create these really amazing dimensional effects when you open up the card and find these fun little scenes inside. I wanted to decorate my card with the Smooth Sailing stamp set from Lanfon. So one of the ways you can attach your images is to add a score line down the center so you can put it right in the middle of the card. However, if you don't want to do that, you could attach it to one of the flat edges of your center picture window panels. However, I want my lighthouse right in the center. So I just created a score line and that lets my lighthouse sit right in the middle of the card. And when I close it, it's going to fold up really, really nicely. I added some other fun embellishments from that Smooth Sailing set. And the sentiments are stamped on cute little banners that I also added some score lines to so that they could fold up really nicely when the card isn't open. I am just loving these scenes. This is such a unique way to add some really amazing interest to your cards. Finally, I can't finish off this card without a little bit of glitter, so I used some Glitter Nouveau drops just because they already are glittery and they're going to hold down some fun Lanfon Prisma glitter, but at the same time, they'll also add additional sparkle and shine. So I used those Glitter Nouveau drops to add some glitter areas to my card, and then I sprinkled on some Lanfon Prisma glitter for some extra sparkle and shine. And I did that to both the inside and the outside of the card on the waves and the lighthouse and also on the little heart that's on the front of the card. This little card was so much fun to make and they really take no time at all to put together. Once you've learned which pieces work together to create these dimensional effects, you can go crazy by adding your own designs and really experimenting with how to create with these dies. I hope that you will check out this die set to be able to create some of these cards yourself. I think you're going to have a lot of fun doing this because I know I sure did. Thanks for tuning in and spending some time with me today. I hope this video was helpful and that you're inspired to create as well. Thanks for tuning in. I will see you again very soon and have a great day. Bye!